Hi everyone, my name is Patrick。大家好，我是中正高中英文科老师吴俊毅。今天呢，我们要来学的是与过去事实相反的假设语气。好，讲到假设语气呢，大家一定对 if 这个字不陌生。好，其实英文的假设语气呢，跟中文的假设语气有没有相似的地方呢？我们先来看一下什么是假设语气，the subjunctive mood。The subjunctive mood in English is the same as that in Chinese. The purpose is very much alike. We make assumptions based on several situations. 好，英文的假设语气呢，跟中文的假设语气一样，我们会根据不同的情况做假设。OK，所以呢，在英文的假设语气呢，其实有分两种。第一种呢，与现在事实相反的假设语气；第二种，与过去事实相反的假设语气。好，那今天呢，我们要着重的重点在于与过去事实相反的假设语气。好，那在开始之前呢，Let's read the story together。我们来一起读一篇小的故事。那大家可以把重点放在假设语气 if。Okay, let's read the story together. Yesterday, my girlfriend and I were in the night market, but it wasn't fun at all. Because both of us were too hungry, we brought many food and snack and thus ran out of our money soon. Even worse, we didn't expect it would rain cat and dog last night, so we were soaking wet and came home earlier. My girlfriend blamed me for not being thoughtful. She said that if I had brought enough money, she wouldn't have become angry about her hunger. What's more, she told me that if I hadn't taken an umbrella, she might not have caught a cold. 在故事的第二段里面，大家可以发现 if 这个关键字在英文的假设句里面呢 ，if 扮演了非常重要的角色。好，老师呢又将下面的句型呢，用红色和蓝色呢做了区别。好，大家可以想想看是为什么呢？在英文的假设句里面呢，我们又分为 if 子句呢跟结论子句。if 它是个连接词，它连接的 if 子句接了逗点，后面呢再接结论子句。接下来呢，要请同学看一下绿色圈圈所代表的时态哦。刚刚我们在看故事的时候，大家都知道这篇故事呢发生在过去所发生的事件。那在英文的假设语态呢，如果呢事情是发生在过去的话呢，我们必须要把时态往后退一步，所以呢就由过去式 past tense 变成了 past perfect tense。所以呢，大家看到绿色圈圈的部分呢，都是过去完成式。我们现在来归纳一下与过去事实相反假设语气的规则。首先呢，我们看到 if 子句里面的公式。好，第一个可以看到呢，有 if 连接词，后面呢接了 subject 主词，主词后面呢再接了 had 或者是 could have， 后面呢再给它一个过去分词。好 ，for example， 我们可以看到例句里面有 if I had known his home address， I wouldn't have got lost。好，大家可以看到在 if 子句里面的时态，我们必须要给它一个 past perfect tense。我们必须要用过去完成式。好，这句话的意思是说呢，如果呢我那时候知道他的住家地址的话，我呢就不会迷路了。也就是说呢，过去的我呢知不知道他的地址呢？事实上是不知道的。这就是与过去事实相反的语气，必须使用过去完成式。接着我们来看一下与过去事实相反假设语气的结论子句。好，如公式，我们可以看到 subject 主词后面呢接的四个助动词分别是 would、should、could、might， 后面呢再接完成式 have， 然后呢后面再给它个过去分词。好，和刚刚的例句一样，我们来看一下哦。If I had known his home address, I wouldn't have got lost。大家把重点这次呢放在结论子句这边。好 ，I wouldn't have got lost。刚刚我们讲到 ，if he had known his home address， 如果呢我那时候知道他的住家地址的话 ，I wouldn't have got lost， 我呢就不会迷路了。但是呢，事实上他有迷路，所以我们把时态从过去式呢往后推一步，变成过去完成式。所以在结论子句呢这边，我们会看到 I wouldn't have got lost 必须呢要有一个完成式。OK，现在你们已经知道与过去式相反假设语气的规则，我们现在就来做一些题目吧。OK，我们来看一下第一题：If Jack（ 括弧 ）study English hard that semester, he（ 括弧 ）would not have to retake the course。好，大家可以想想看，底线的答案是什么？好。我们来揭晓答案。If Jack had studied English hard that semester, he wouldn't have had to retake the course。好，来看一下 if 子句里面呢。If Jack had studied English hard that semester，大家可以发现原本的原形动词 study 啊，因为呢后面的 that semester 是过去式。所以呢，我们先把 study 变成了 studied 过去式，但是呢，这里呢，因为呢，它过去呢并没有认真读英文，所以呢，与过去式是相反。好，我们学到了与过去式是相反呢，我们必须要把 study 过去式呢变成 had studied，把 study 变成过去完成式 had studied。所以呢，我们会在 if 子句看到 if Jack had studied。English hard last semester。那接着呢，我们来看一下结论子句：He wouldn't have had to retake the course。原本呢，主词 he 后面呢接的是 will not have to，但是呢，我们刚刚讲到这句话的时态是在 last semester，是在上学期的事情，所以呢，我们第一步骤要先把助动词 will 改成 would 的。好，把 will 改成 would。好，那这呢就直接在 would 后面变成 wouldn't。好，那么呢后面记得哦，与过去式相反的假设语气呢，必须给它一个完成式 have，所以呢变成了 he wouldn't have。好，那因为呢 have to 它是一个动词片语，原本呢是发生在过去式是 had to，但是呢因为遇到了完成式 have，所以呢我们要把 had to 变成了过去分词 had to。好，所以呢，答案就变成了 He wouldn't have had to retake the course。好，这样子大家有没有比较清楚呢？OK，我们先来看一下第二题。If Kathy's parents（ 括弧 ）be in her birthday party last night, there（ 括弧 ）might not be so many people in her house。好，大家一样注意，在这个假设语态中的时态是发生在过去式。OK，我们来揭晓答案。答案是：If Kathy's parents had been in her birthday party last night, there might not have been so many people in her house。好，我们先来看一下 if 子句这边：If Kathy's parents had been in her birthday party last night。好，原本的题目呢给的是 be 动词原形 be，但是呢，因为我们时间是发生在过去时间，所以呢，Kathy's parents 复数原本是要用 be 动词 were。were，但是呢，这个时间呢是发生在过去式，所以呢，我们学到了与过去式是相反的假设语态呢，我们必须用过去完成式，所以呢，答案就变成了 had been。好，接着呢，在结论子句这边的答案是 there might not have been so many people in her house，一样呢，因为这个时态是发生在过去式，所以呢，原本题目给的是 may not be，所以呢，我们要把答案的助动词 may not 变成 might not，那一样呢？我们说与过去事实相反的假设语态，必须给它一个完成式 have，所以呢，我们会看到 might not 后面马上接了一个 have，然后呢，最后的 be 动词再把它变成过去分词 been，所以呢，答案就变成了 might not have been。好，这样子大家清楚吗？OK，我们现在来看一下第三题。If Hamilton（ 括弧 ）come home earlier yesterday, he（ 括弧 ）will have enough time to finish his homework。好，大家一样要注意一下时态呢，是在过去式 yesterday。好，我们来看一下答案。If Hamilton had come home earlier yesterday, he would have had enough time to finish his homework。好，我们先来看一下 if 子句这边的答案。If Hamilton had come home earlier yesterday，好，原本题目的动词给你的是 come，但是呢，我们因为与过去式相反的假设语气，必须用过去完成式，所以呢，答案就变成了 had come。 特别注意的是，原本的动词呢是过去式 came，但是呢变成了过去分词，所以呢就变成了 come。答案再念一次：If Hamilton had come home earlier yesterday，如果呢他昨天呢有早点回家的话。好，再来结论子句这边呢，He would have had enough time to finish his homework。好，一样呢，题目原本给你的是 will have。但是呢，与过去事实相反的假设语气，我们必须助动词用过去式 would，后面呢再给它一个完成式 have，最后呢，原本题目给你的动词是拥有，拥有足够的时间来完成回家作业。好，拥有 have 就要变成了过去分词 had，所以呢，答案就变成了 He would have had enough time to finish his homework。这样子大家清楚吗？我们接下来做下一题。If Richardson（括弧 know the condition of his mother, he（括弧 will quit his job and（括弧 stay with his mother。一样注意时态是发生在过去式。好，我们来揭晓一下答案。If Richardson had known the condition of his mother, he would have quit his job and stay with his mother。好，我们来先来看一下 if 子句这边，If Richardson had known the condition of his mother，原本的动词呢，在题目中是给你 know 原形动词，但是呢，我们题目呢，因为我们知道的是与过去事实相反的假设语态，所以呢，一样，我们把时态呢变成过去完成式，给它加上来一个 had，所以答案就变成了 If Richardson had known the condition of his mother。如果呢，他当时知道他妈妈的情况，接着我们在结论子句这边呢，看到了 he would have quit his job and stay with his mother。好，原本呢，题目给的是 will quit and 的原形动词 stay。那因为呢，与过去事实相反的假设语气呢，我们必须使用助动词在结论句中，所以呢，我们把 will 变成了过去式助动词 would，然后呢，后面再接完成式 have。最后呢，再接 quit。大家要特别注意的是，quit 的三态是一样的，quit、quit、quit。所以呢，我们的 quit 还是保持原来的心态。再来，后面这个动词 stay，原本是原形动词，但是呢，一样，它因为前面有 and 对的连接词，所以呢，我们后面要把它改成
过去分词
stay with his mother。好，所以呢，再念一次，结论子句呢，就变成了。He would have quit his job and stay with his mother. OK，以上是与过去式相反的假设语气用法，大家学会了吗？I'll see you next time. 拜拜。